Thus far, I have shown you arrays which have only a single dimension. That means it has only one row. It is very much possible, like a matrix in maths, for an array to have more than one dimension. That means it can have a row or a column together. So arrays can have as many dimensions as you want, but generally two or three is probably the most you will end up be working with. One of the challenges is, if you go beyond three dimensions, it becomes extremely difficult to visualize it and take a look at how it really is stored. So a two-dimensional array is similar to a matrix in maths, where you have done matrix addition, matrix multiplication, matrix subtraction, and so on. Suppose I declare a two-dimensional array with the name A holding integer data. 3 represents the number of rows and 4 represents the number of columns. That is, the first square bracket represents the rows, the second square bracket represents the number of columns. So if I have to refer to an element like, say, 11, so what I will say is, I will say A of 0, 0. First the row comes, then the column. 0 refers to the 0th row and 0 refers to the 0th column. As you are aware, we start both the rows and columns from 0, not from 1. That's why although I say 3 rows, we are starting from 0, so I have 0, 1 and 2. Although I say 4 columns, since we are starting from 0, it is 0, 1 and 2 and 3. So if I have to refer to element 32, it is going to be A of 1 here, and where it is joining, A of 1, 1 will refer to 32. Instead of using constant numbers, I will generally use variables I and j to refer to the row and column respectively. So I refers to this row, j refers to the given column, like this. A better way to understand a multidimensional array is to take a look at a simple example where I am going to show you how a two-dimensional array is going to be initialized with certain numbers and how I am going to print numbers out of this two-dimensional array. Before I go to the actual program, let me tell you what I am doing. For 10 students, I have taken exam, and exam for 5 subjects. For each of those 5 subjects, in each row, I am storing the marks for each student. For example, let's say roll number 1. His marks are 50, 80, 90, 100 and 78. Roll number 2. His or her marks are 30, 10, 20, 70 and 58. So I have declared an integer variable called as roll number. J will help me go through this individual columns. Okay, so roll number will help me go through the particular row for the student, and J will help me to go through the particular column for that particular student. So the size of the two-dimensional array is, it contains 10 rows and then it contains 5 columns. Now, since it contains 10 rows, the 0th row I have initialized with 50, 80, 90, 100 and 78. So it has got 5 columns. The second row I have initialized, or the first in C, is 30, 10, 20, 70 and 58. So this way I have initialized all 10 rows with 5 subject marks. So the first thing I am going to do is, I am going to ask the student, or I am going to ask the user, enter the roll number of the student between 1 to 10. So say for example, I am going to read the roll number of roll number 3. So it should print 40, 20, 30, 90 and 58, which are the marks of 5 subjects. Now what I am doing is, for J is equal to 0, why I am taking this J is equal to 0 is, because I know my row is fixed. This is the row which is fixed. But for each of the subject, the J should keep increasing so that I am able to print the marks for that particular row and column combination. So let's say it's roll number 3. Since I am saying it's roll number 3, let us keep this side. So I'll help you visualize it a little better. Okay. So I am saying roll number is 3. Okay. Roll number is 3. J is 0. J is less than 5 because I want to print this entire row. Now marks of roll number percentage D. marks of roll number percentage D refers to this variable, that is marks of roll number 3. Then why I am doing J plus 1 is J refers to the 0th subject marks. But we'll real life, we don't talk about 0th subject. We talk about the first subject. Then this is important. Marks of roll number minus 1 and J. Now marks refers to this. Roll number is 3. But since I am starting from 0, so I am doing roll number minus 1. So 3 minus 1 is 2. So 0, 1, 2. So I am coming to this row where 40 is here. And then J value is 0. So initially, this is roll number, this becomes 2 and 0. Row 2 and 0 is 40. So first it will print 40 here. Next, J is increased by 1. J becomes 1. This row remains constant. So second row, first column. So it is 20. Next it will print 20. Then after that, what happens is, J is increased by 1 more. J becomes 2. When J becomes 2, roll number is common. 2, 2 is 30. This way it will print 30. Then J becomes 3. So it is 2, 3 is 90. Then finally 2, 4 is 58. This way the marks for the 5 subject for that particular student are going to be printed one after the other. So this is how you initialize a two-dimensional array and how you go about printing the values. Each row is preferably initialized in a flower bracket. There is comma between numbers and there is comma after each row. This way your initialization is very clear. If you had to read numbers, you would say instead of printf, you would say scanf percentage d marks of I J. This should be your way of reading numbers for marks of ith student and jth subject. Now, just one thing I just want to tell you. The way arrays are stored in C is a technique called as row major. What you mean by row major is, first, all these 50, 80, 90, 100, 78 is first stored. Suppose I have an array, the array which I was talking about before at the very beginning. Suppose I have this particular array A of 3, 4. So what is going to happen is, this 11, 56, 0 and minus 8 is going to be stored sequentially in the memory. After the first row is stored, the second row 85, 32, alright, minus 7 and 4 is going to be stored, followed by the third row. So this way of storing the elements one row after other in a sequence in the memory is referred to as the row major order of representation. In C, we use the row major order of representation of arrays. In certain programming language, you use the column major. What is the column major? Instead of storing the rows first, it will store this column first, then this column and this column. This information is important for you when you go to data structures. That's where this knowledge is going to be quite helpful for you.